Yo guys, what is up? This is Nick. We are back on Fallout 3. I looked up the video. I know how to do it. So whenever I get to level 29, I know how to do it. It's not that hard. It's exactly what I thought it was. But you know, always a good,
Full
always,
pass.
100%, always a good idea to second to check yourself, make sure that you're not gonna make a mistake, because it would suck to make the mistake and lose out on 40 gamer scores since, you know, I'm an achievements whore. Curse some of my friends for getting me into getting a gamer score. Let's see here. The culmination of 6 years, 122,779. Actually, it's like 5 years. But I could have a lot more if I didn't 10th prestige every Call of Duty other than Ghosts and Advanced Warfare. And I could have a whole lot more if I actually 1,000. If I 1,000 all of the games that, or if I max gamer score all the games I put into my Xboxes, I think I'd be somewhere around like 450,000. But some games I just didn't like, and then some games I still have some games I'm gonna get gamer score in, like Witcher 2. I never beat Witcher 2. Somehow it went in my Xbox. So at some point I played it. Don't ask me when. I don't remember. But I think my 360 has my t between my like okay, I had four 360s, but not because they broke, they were just special editions. And I kind of wish I wouldn't have sold my Halo Reach one, but I did, so that's a thing, I guess. But so I don't know, where is this ship? Guess I'll just follow this path and keep talking, but my Halo Reach one, I actually let my friend borrow it, and then we were no longer friends, because she got pissed at me for like no reason whatsoever, and so I was just like, you know what, I'm done with you, I'm done. And so I got my Xbox back finally from her, but it was all scratched up and shit, and I kind of took advantage of a friend, kind of, not really, but I sold it to him for like 100. And I think it was 190 or something like that, 180, 190. And so I thought that was a pretty good deal for it. It was pretty badly scratched, and she broke the controller. So he had controllers. It was just he didn't have his Xbox. Just I guess it just gave out. Like mine's kind of given out. My Modern Warfare 3 Xbox, it's kind of given out. So I have to be honest, it's on its last leg. I might be switching to a PlayStation 3 for older games, if it ever gives out. It's mostly the disc tray. I guess I could still play all the games I have installed on it. It's really just the disc tray that gives issues, but it also has issues with HDMI. Sometimes it wants to, what am I trying to say? It wants to not register HDMI, so it won't let me set the TV to 1080i, so it won't show up on the TV correctly, and then I have all sorts of issues getting that shit back to normal. But it's been great for me. I love Xbox. I've had no problem with mine. I know people, you know, lots of people have problems with like the red rings and all that different stuff, but I've taken really good care of my Xboxes and all my games and stuff like that, and haven't had any issues. So I think if you just take care of your stuff, and you know, you be mindful of different things, I don't think you'll have any problems with an Xbox. Like I haven't had any problems with my Xbox, or I never had a problem with an Xbox or a PS3. So I'm not really in the business of like having console war arguments, but in my opinion, I like the Xbox more than the PlayStation. But that doesn't mean I think it's a better
You
console.
infiltrated those tribals yet?
Yes, I'm in. I found out where their leader is hiding.
And you didn't go track him down and grill him for information. I'm not your daddy. Don't waste your time checking in. Go find him and figure out what he wants with this place, you moron.
Okay.
Back to bit.
I'm going. All right, what was I rambling on about? But I'm not a big like console wars guy. Like, it's really just preference. There's not a whole lot of difference between each console. Even if one is better, there's not a huge difference between the other consoles. Like with the Xbox 360 and the PS3, the biggest problem the PS3 had for a while is no party chat. That was one of its big issues, but I guess you could solve that pretty easily with Skype. That's just kind of annoying that you or like TeamSpeak or whatever, all those different sites that you, but that's just kind of a little bit of annoyance to have to use other sites to talk to your friends, but I guess it worked, so but that was one of the biggest differences, and Xbox had a lot better exclusives on 360 slash PS3. The PS3 had Uncharted, God of War, Killzone, Mag. I don't know, one of those, it's probably, that's near all the exclusives, I can't even think. Oh, Infamous. Is that it? That might be it. They had Demon Souls, I guess, but that's pretty old at this point. I don't know if you really want to count that as. What the hell? Okay, you got some tech. But, and then the Xbox had Halo, Gears. It had more like multiplayer fun games with friends type of stuff. It wasn't just single player like Infamous and all that different stuff. What else did Xbox have? Xbox had Fable, I guess. That's really that great of an exclusive. It's really hard to think of what exclusives the Xbox had. The Xbox had better exclusives. I'm just drawing a blank on what those exclusives were. Halo and Gears are the big thing. Gears is amazing. Halo's amazing. Used to not like Halo, but I do like Halo now. Like, I changed my opinion on it. Am I really? Really? No. Come here. Thank you. Ahead and reload that. But yeah, I've never been a big guy to argue consoles, like which one's better. Like, I just don't care. I'm gonna play my Xbox, you're gonna play your PlayStation. Let's just leave it at that. Who cares? Past that. There, I don't know. It really just never mattered to me. Like, it'd be nice if, like, some of my friends who have PlayStations had Xbox. One friend in particular. But, you know, it's whatever. Whatever. From like my school days, lots of a couple of, so a decent amount of my friends have stopped playing Xbox or PlayStation altogether. They're more focused on college, which I probably should be too. Honestly, I should probably care more about school than Xbox, but I don't. I'm gonna be honest, but I should probably care more about school, and I need to pick it up with school. Not that I failed any classes in college, I'm just behind. This injury put me behind, and just a bunch of different stuff has set me back. I took a semester off because I didn't want to waste my parents' money, because they are paying for me to go. So I didn't want to waste their money by going for a semester and not know what on earth I was doing. So I did sit out a semester. I forfeited last semester because of this injury. So I am sitting at a junior. I think I'm sitting at like 40. No, not 40. Like 50 credits or something like that. I'm hovering around there, I think. Like upper 50s. So this is. So I need to go down here. But I'm sitting like upper 50s because I got some credits from high school. Oh shit. That break my feet. Let's see. No, it didn't. Actually it didn't. Okay. But it I'm sitting, I got some credits from high school. I got some credits for my SAT scores. I got exempted from some classes, so I'm not as far behind as I could be, but I think it's somewhere. It depends on what major I end up with, I guess, technically. If I stick with the major I'm at now, I'm sitting at like 40 something, but if I change majors, I think I'm sitting high 40s no matter what. I could be wrong. It wouldn't be a surprise if I was wrong, but I think I'm sitting high 40s. But enough about me and school. Enough about that shit. I feel like I talk about it all the time. Oh shit. This pistol is not bad with the Grim Reaper. This thing might be what I roll with for this DLC because pre-war money. No, I don't want to drink. I want to loot. I want the pre-war money. Why am I even worrying about this? Double barrel hype! Why is there just a bunch of pre-war money sitting in here? I don't even know what I just took. I don't want it. Take it back. I don't want your meat. I want the pre-war. Oh, this is shotgun shells. I definitely want the. You need to get out. Come here. Get out of there. You ass. You ass hat. I want the shotgun shells and the pre-war money. This dick has to be in the way. No, I don't wanna. No! I want the pre-war money. Don't ask me why I want the pre-war money, but I do. Yeah, let's continue. Okay, so I guess I gotta go around. The game isn't gonna be nice. Where the hell am I supposed to be going? So maybe I wasn't supposed to come down here. Yeah, I think. No, I wasn't. To go around this way. Whew. But I was going to be doing an online speech class this summer, trying to make up a few credits, and you actually needed like 14 people to come to your house to do the. You had to record yourself doing the speech, which was no problem. Like, I have all the equipment to do that. I just don't have 14 people to call 5 times in. Like, I can't make my. I don't want to make my friends come over and listen to me give a speech. Like, that's just being a horrible friend. Like, I don't have 14 people. Like, I'm not gonna make them come over to my house 5 times. Like, that's just ridiculous. Like, I'm not gonna make them drop what they're doing to come over and listen to me give a stupid ass speech. So I'm just gonna take speech class next summer, I think, and do it in person. So don't ever do an online speech class, 'cause that shit's just awful. Whoever thought that was a good idea,
No
oh, let's make
longer
them
shouts
just
mystical
have to have
pleasure.
a shit ton.
At last, yes! Desmond will die, and our long struggle will finally end the only way it could have, with me as the victor!
Yes, and you will be able to spread your.
No, not astral knowledge,
My meditation
simpleton! Psychic
requires utmost
domination, and that still
concentration.
won't be possible until you destroy Desmond's jamming device!
No need to worry, enlightened one. We shall reconsecrate the mansion and remove the impurities disrupting your perfect guidance.
Yes, fine. Go destroy the house and its impurities. Just stop that jammer, and I'll be free of you morons once and for all.
Yes, we shall be free of all limitations. Thank you, Master. We shall be the instrument of your mighty will.
Transcend. Hello? You are a fellow seeker of the higher planes, perhaps. What brings you here?
I just wanted to meet the tribal leader.
I may be the man who leads our physical affairs, but I cannot claim true wisdom. I take my orders from a higher master, whether it be how to explore higher planes or the decision to remove the disruptive ghoul. All wisdom comes from the transcendent master.
You mean you're really not the one in charge?
Would that I was so wise. No. True leadership of the tribe belongs to the higher mind of the enlightened one. Although his mind has moved beyond the need for flesh, his consciousness still returns here to guide our people. I merely interpret his wishes. He manifests here, high on a ledge in the great sea cave's well. Perhaps if you are fortunate, he will choose to share his wisdom with you.
I'll go see the Transcendent Master now.
Yes. Commune with him while I see to my tribe. There is much to be done.
Yes, fellow seeker.
The hell? I'll go see the tr. Okay, good. I was like, what the hell?
So you're the mouse that was scurrying around here? Not much to look at, but at least you're not drooling all over yourself. I can work with that. Now then, perhaps you can be more useful than that simpering spiritualist and his tribe of idiots.
Useful. What are you using the tribe for?
At the moment, they've been no use at all, but I have very few options. They can't even seem to remove a single ghoul from our house.
What have you got against the ghoul?
More than you could possibly imagine with your squishy pink mind. But the only pressing matter at the moment is a device in his possession. He has a jammer that limits my projection range to this pathetic cave. Remove that, and I can extend my reach so much further. Killing Desmond would be a nice plus, but I'm sure we can get around to that later.
Okay. I guess I have to do. So there's the level up. Level 20, or 27. So we still got two more levels to go. I still gotta go to 28 and then 29. So should start putting stuff in the sneak, but no, we're gonna put it into barter. No, I don't need it into barter. We'll go to 60 barter. Bring that up to 50. Let's bring this up to 20. Bring that up to 20. Bring that up to 20. Let's put the rest into explosives. All right, what perks do we got? Okay, I don't want any of that stuff. The price of every item you buy from a vendor is reduced by 25%. That might be what we're gonna get right there. Yeah, we're gonna take that perk. Okay, thought control. Let's see, what does this quest? Okay, so we need to speak with Desmond. I'm gonna beat Jackson out of this cave. I don't know what the hell he's meandering around about. Vision battery? What the hell are people keeping shit in coffins for? But back to what I was saying, with 14 people, you gotta have 15 technically. 14 and a cameraman. And yourself. And I was like, for one, there are some people that I could ask. Like, I don't have, well, yeah, I probably do. I was gonna say I don't have 14 really good friends that would come sit over, but I don't have 14 really good friends that I will hang out with together. Like, I have different friends. Like, I have friends that I like, that like video games, so we became friends because I like video games. There's some friends I have that love sports, that's why we became friends, because we both love sports. And then I have friends that, you know, we just have like the same personalities, or we have contradicting personalities that work out well together. Alright, there's an autosave. I was gonna save, because that kind of worried me when it kind of... Okay, I need to heal. Oh, I need to heal. Oh, shit. He actually almost scared the shit out of me, because I was like, oh, I need to heal, and then I turned and there's a Swamp Lurk just standing there, and I love you, Swamp Lurk, because you give me 49 experience. Okay, let's see if I can just fast travel back to the Citadel. Or fast travel back to the... No! There's an enemy nearby! F you! You can take so many shots. Nope, you're dead. Come here, bitch. I killed it. Can I fast travel now? I don't think there's any more enemies. I think that's it. Come on, game. Let me fast travel. Yes! Yes! But I mean, like, I don't hang out with them all at the same time, so it'd be kind of weird. And, yeah, it'd be a little weird having all of them over at the same time. And then, obviously, you know, I got my parents, I got my cousins, I got my aunt and uncle, but they don't equal enough around my house, like, that I could get quickly. Like, they don't all live, like, all my aunts and uncles and all my cousins, and, like, they don't all live around my house. Like, I can't just grab all of them in, like, a hurry. I mean, I got my grandma. There are a couple, I guess I could maybe get to 20, but, or to 14, but it would be extremely close. And there are some people outside my window looking at me. Yeah, go away. Yeah, that's what I thought. I don't think they could hear me. But no, that's annoying. I hate, like, what are you doing? Why are you just staring into people's houses? Why do you gotta be a weirdo? Hey, let's talk to Desmond.
I knew it. I knew that little bastard was behind all this. After all these years, he stuck his head out, and this is my chance to cut it off. Figuratively speaking, of course.
So who is this brain thing?
Him. I should have known. My old rival, so close to his family home. Only he would be so stupid. He was once a man, Professor Calvert. The Calverts owned half of Maryland, back when there was a Maryland to own. Members of the Calvert family were influential all over the world. They practically owned a deed to the U.S. government. In their best days, there were no less than 3 Calvert family senators, 7 members of the House, and 2 governors. They even had a top candidate for president, until that scandal with the dog forced them to drop out of the race. I was particularly proud of that one.
So now you want me to do something else, right?
Of course I fucking want you to do something else. You don't expect me to trot around this mud hole myself, do you?
Maybe you should watch your tone, old man.
Or what? You think I haven't been shot before? Think that you, over the thousands who have tried, can take me down? You'd best wise the hell up and play along. I'll get what I want, and you'll get rich, and then we can go about our separate goddamn ways.
What do you want me to do then? Oh no, oh wait. Oh, I can't wait to hear this.
So, those half-wits are getting messages from the professor, right? So he's off somewhere broadcasting to them. But without those buggers to do things for him, he can't do much for himself. So, we cut off his ability to talk to them, and he'll need to try harder. Maybe then I can find this squishy little worm and finish him off for good.
Okay, what's your plan, old man?
If I know Professor Calvert, and I do, he's using a high-frequency cognitive sign broadcast. I have the perfect device to jam up his little talk box. All you need to do is take it to the highest point on the shore and install it. Easy, right?
The big wheel down by the docks, right?
Right. Attach it to the bottom car, then turn it on and spin the jammer to the top. No fucking problem. I'll watch from here and turn it on. Then we'll see where our little professor is. Now, go!
Alright, you little shit. Okay, let's go install the cogwave jammer on the Ferris wheel. I don't even remember what I was talking about before I talked to him. Now there's a train outside. Man, I don't know if I can go. I can't even go a recording session without a train blaring in the background. Like, it's just gonna be a staple of my videos. Train. Train noises in the background. That's my niche. Who else on YouTube has train noises in the background of their videos? Let's go Pilgrim's Landing. It's good that I can fast travel around here now. A lot more to do. So I'm listening to a Bloodborne playthrough by one of my favorite YouTubers, Jumpin' Productions. I'm really disappointed that I wanted to get a PS4, but I couldn't really justify like $300 or whatever it is, plus 60 for Bloodborne to buy the game. I just could not justify it to myself. And I think most people would agree with me, but I just couldn't justify spending that much money for one game. Because there's not really anything else on PlayStation, and I've invested so much time on Xbox with GamerScore. I can't just give up Xbox, like, I can't just give it up for a PlayStation. I know people are probably like, yeah. Is this where the Ferris wheel is? Yeah, it is. I need to get inside there, alright. That makes more sense. But people are like, oh, just give up your Xbox and get a PlayStation. They're like, that's not what I want to do. Like, I've invested so much time with Xbox that at this point, I'm bound to it for life. Or unless it just discontinues, then I get a PlayStation.
It but is I'll end up getting Professor Calvert! Don't bother looking around, I'm in your mind! But aren't you Desmond's faithful little employee? Coming to gum up my work, are we? Well, I have a better idea. How about instead of playing his game, you destroy that nasty little device? Deposit it in the nearby trash compactor and we will never have to worry about it again. I assure you that the gratitude of Professor Calvert is worth a great deal more than that of a washed-up old limey.
Okay, now how do I turn this?
You fool! What have you done? You will pay for this! Pay! Okay. No one betrays me! Do you understand? You will suffer for this! You-
Oh, I am so scared.
Both pay! coming for you.
Found you.
You the Punga. Hey, tribal little bitches. Oh, damn. Bitch. But Bloodborne looks like so much fun.
Leap forever.
But I'm happy Dark Souls 3 got announced. Cannot wait for that thing to come out. It's gonna be a while till that comes out, but I still can't wait till it comes out. Is that really all the tribals you sent to kill me? That's pathetic. That's a joke. Oh, more enemies. Where? Where is this other enemy? Oh boy, you were difficult. Where are the... I'm getting hit, but there's nothing for me to lock onto. There you are, you little shit. Come here. No, don't. You are literally a little shit. Stop hiding, you stupid ass. You're dead. Yeah, one shot, bitch. Get dropped. Okay, I think that should be it. No, there's still enemies. Oh, there's one over here. Let's go ahead and get to a place where I can see it. Where the hell? Oh, there you are. Bitch! Come here! How are these not hitting you? There we go. Okay, now can I fast travel? There we go, now I can fast travel. That wasn't bad. We're on our way to 28. On our way to 28. I have a feeling it's going to get interesting after I get to 28. Like, once I beat this DLC, which I don't think there's much longer to go, then time, then getting experience. Whoa. Whoa! Whoa! What the hell? Desmond? Sought control, mission complete. A meeting of the minds, quest added. Oh, you know what? He has that failsafe room. Aha, I forgot about that. He's got that failsafe room.
That bastard. He killed my pups. Nearly killed me. For what? He doesn't have the body to fucking do it himself. So he tried to blow me up. Me? Well, this ends today. Desmond Lockhart will finally win out. I know where he is. He overplayed his hand this time. You and me are going to walk in there and end this.
Ah, it's great to... you know what? It's great to see you alive, Desmond. I was kind of worried you died.
Well, aren't you a fucking softy? But Calvert is here. He's got a lab under the lighthouse, the little fuck. Right under my nose the whole time. I found it when he boosted his signal to try to get through the jamming, when he sent those tribals to kill my poor pups. He's down there, hiding behind robots and machines, sucking life. Pathetic. He dies now.
Then let's get in there and
now,
do this.
That's more like it. Follow me. You're about to witness the end of an era.
All right, homie. What do you got down here? Before we head out, you got some wine. You got some dirty water. Who doesn't like some dirty water? Oh, a Nuka-Cola Quantum. Well, I'll take those bobby pins. Ooh, Nuka-Cola. Oh, he's just got ammo. Scope. Don't know why I'm taking this power armor. I'll probably end up dropping it later. Okay, let's go ahead and repair some stuff, I guess. Repair it with that. Repair the double barrel. Take those blood packs. Okay, let's head up. Let's do this, Desmond! I don't remember who I helped before. I don't remember if I helped Desmond or if I helped the brain, if I helped Calvert. Alrighty, Desmond. Where, how do we get in? Where are you going? The lighthouse is over there. Is there another entrance over here? Okay. Alright, Desmond, that was a weird way to go down this hill. I'm not sure why you ran over that way. Look, he's about to walk on water. Oh no, I guess. I was gonna say, I bet he's gonna walk on water while I have to swim, but no, there's actually. Oh. What the hell is he doing? Okay, that made no sense. It's like the game heard me and wanted to make sure he swam a little bit. That was weird. That was really weird. That was really freaking weird. Yay, 13 experience. All right, guys. I'm gonna call it an episode right here, and the next one we will be going inside of here to take on Calvert, and so I will catch you all then. Peace out, guys.